Look at that. That car is now in the middle of the river. It started out.
This is one of the most fun things I think I get to do because it lets me think like a kid, act like a kid in a way.
Each classroom that comes here, we have, I believe, 45 classrooms that come out today and spend the day learning about water. And it's anything from seeing water critters, or it talks about non-point source pollution, so what we do on the land and how it goes to storm sewers and goes to rivers and lakes.
See all the red in the system? What you just put into this well is going to flow through the entire groundwater system and end up getting pumped up along the way, or put into a lake or river, or if that's just regular water, it's not wastewater, it could be contaminated by one of these leaky landfills, which is gross. You don't want that in your drinking water. That's not good for you.
And pretty soon the Gulf of Mexico is going to overflow.
The Met Council, as you know, treats the wastewater for the entire metropolitan area. And so we have a direct influence on the quality of the water that is found in the receiving water bodies of the area, in the Minnesota River and the St. Croix River and the Mississippi River, all of which have wetlands along their shores. So what we do, how well we treat our wastewater, can influence the ecology of those wetland areas along rivers.
Well, I mean, the stream work that we're doing is a really important part of what the Met Council is doing. All the land use decisions that we make, all of the land use changes, inevitably affect the runoff, and they affect the streams. We change the vegetation, we change the impervious surface, so the amount of water that's getting into our streams. And so all of those development choices that we make affect our streams, and that in turn affects the amount of erosion, the types of sediments in the stream, the different pollutants that are going from our streams in the metropolitan area all the way down into the Gulf of Mexico. And so the choices we're making here, you know, are affecting the entire globe, which is, you know, sounds extreme, but you know, it's all connected.
Water connects us all, and it's important, and it's, you know, as important to you as it is to me and to the next person, and we can all make a difference of, you know, improving it and keeping it for future generations, because again, it is the essence of life.